Good morning. Welcome to Earth and Sky Center. Thank you for joining us here in person. And those of you joining us online, we really appreciate your views, your likes, and your shares. It really boosts my day each time I see another one of you liking or sharing our videos. So thank you very much for that. We always love your feedback and your comments as well. Last week, we talked about 10 steps to increase your intuition. I hope you enjoyed that. And we're going to break that apart into much smaller bite-sized pieces as well. We covered a lot in that overall video. So today we're going to start talking about how to be empathic, and not only how to be empathic, but how to be a healthy, happy, successful empath. So some people feel like they would really like to increase their ability to be empathic. People tend to be born with varying levels. Some people are born wide open and they're very empathic, and they might even feel like it's a curse instead of a blessing because they get overwhelmed feeling all of the emotions of everybody else. If you haven't already, please hit the like button on our Facebook page. Please subscribe to us on YouTube. And so there's several different things that are kind of interesting with this topic. Neuroscientists have actually been really studying a lot of things with the brain pertaining to this too. And they found that humans are wired to experience empathy through multiple systems of mirror neurons in the brain. So if you think about how you know how somebody's feeling on even a more basic level, if you see someone smile, often our mirror neurons will trigger us to smile as well. And we have a wide range of emotions like that, but our bodies are designed, our minds are designed to mirror whatever we're looking at. So if you're talking to people and you want them to feel like you're engaging them, or you want them to feel happy, smile, and then you'll notice that's contagious to them as well. And so that's one aspect with the mirror neurons. But there's a specific region in the brain, and it's actually really interesting as well with those mirror neurons. They've actually done other studies with people that get Botox and things that actually kind of paralyze the muscles in the face, and they found it's fascinating because people tend to have a much harder time really being able to understand and empathize. They can't understand the emotions that other people have, and they've attributed that to them not being able to mirror it within themselves. And so they're finding this is really becoming quite a big thing as people have that, and they can't, you know, change their forehead lines. They don't crease anymore, the around their eyes, they stop. And it's so interesting that they then are not able to understand the emotions of others quite as well as they normally would have. And so the part in the brain that is responsible for all of this fascinating work is in the cerebral cortex. It's called the supra, I have to look at my notes here, supramarginal gyrus, which even in itself is an interesting name. You think supra, super, marginal, not so super, and gyrus. So it's part something that, you know, is flexible and can have a wide range of things that come in and process and spin back out and give you the information. And so this supramarginal gyrus is located in the cerebral cortex, and it's right at the junction between the temporal, the parietal, and the frontal lobes, which makes a lot of sense in and of itself as well. If you're learning to mirror people's emotions and you're understanding not just what you think and feel about a situation, but how does somebody else think and feel about a situation? They might be very different from you. They might have a completely opposing viewpoint, or they might be just a little different than you, or maybe they think just like you. How do you mirror and know all of what's going on? Well, having it at the junction of all of those critical points of the brain, there's a lot that goes in the temporal, the parietal, and the frontal lobes, having it in that real central cortex there makes it so whatever's processing within the brain, you can pick up, because everything we think about has the potential to have different emotions, different feelings, different associations attached to it. And truly, that's kind of partly how to be more empathic, is to be able to really reach out of your normal comfort zone, to really reach out to understand what somebody else is going through, to think what are they possibly thinking? Are they really on the same wavelength of me, or are they thinking something else? And how can I put myself in their shoes? So one of the biggest steps of becoming more empathic is stepping out of your own viewpoint and starting to imagine what it feels like to have the viewpoint of someone else. And you can imagine this with somebody that just thinks a little bit differently than you. How would it feel like to think like them through life? Put yourself in a lot of different scenarios. How would it feel like to be maybe somebody you know even? How, really imagine yourself in their shoes and think about how you would make decisions, how you would form your life if you were in their shoes using their viewpoint instead of your own. And then take that a step further with someone who's quite a bit different than you and think about what it would be like to live their life making decisions from their viewpoint. And then do it a third step further, and this one might really kind of push you more, but think of somebody who's very vastly different from you. Maybe you really disagree with them on certain things, but try to see things from their point of view. Don't villainize it. Don't put your own judgment on it. Instead, think, well, there's probably a reason that they think the way that they do, and try to maybe understand the reasoning behind it, but it's not even as much about understanding the reasoning as it is just understanding what they're thinking, why they make the decisions that they make. This is often seen with the Republican and Democrat thing right now because there's so many different views, and it's not that one is right and one is wrong, even though we may have our own feelings about that. That's our own personal feeling. It's an interesting thing with our country that things will sway both directions with it, sometimes more so than other times. But it's not that one way is right or wrong, so maybe even in that instance that's a little emotionally charged right now, see if you can put yourself in someone on the opposing side and think about how they come to the viewpoints that they have. How do they have emotion behind it? Because really, pretty much all humans, whether it's somebody just like you or somebody vastly different, we all want the same things. We want safety, we want comfort, we want our friends and our family to be healthy and loved, and we want to have a certain base of comforts in our lives. And how we get there and how we feel like we want to extend that to others can be vastly, vastly different. So really try to put yourself in those different three states of mind and see how other people would feel, how they come to those emotions, leaving your own opinion and your own judgment completely out of it. Because if you're going to be empathic, picking up on the emotions of others, if you can set yourself aside, it's going to help you to not feel so overwhelmed when somebody has a different viewpoint, because you'll be able to see it without judgment, to see it without feeling like something is really wrong in you for seeing or feeling whatever it is you're feeling. And then that you're going to also want to listen with all of your senses. So we talked a little bit about this last week, but listening not just with your ears. Definitely part of empathy is listening with your ears because you want to hear what the other person is saying, but really look at the person you're dealing with. Look at their body language. Look at the lines on their face. Do they have a genuine smile where you're seeing all those little lines right around the eyes? Or is their mouth smiling, but their eyes just aren't? Look inside their eyes. When you really stare into somebody's eyes, it's a window to the soul. So you can see so much about that person if you really kind of blink everything out around them and look right into the eyes. Within our eyes, we're not so different from each other. We may dress in different clothes, have different colors of skin. We may have all kinds of different socioeconomic differences, but our eyes truly are windows to the soul. And at the soul level, we all come from that same thread. We all come from this place of love, and we all go back there regardless of whatever we do while we're here. And so listening with all of the senses, stepping out of yourself, seeing how other people think, feel, react, how they make their decisions. Those are all key points to really developing more empathy and setting your own opinions and judgments to the side for it. And empathic people have really, truly have five really great strengths. They tend to be very compassionate. They tend to have a strong intuition. They have a lot of depth within themselves. And they tend to have a very deep connection to other people and a deep connection to the earth as a general. And so if you're wanting to increase the intuition within yourself, or the empathy specifically within yourself, then maybe work on some of those facets. Are you a compassionate person? Are you able to see when somebody is suffering or someone has stuff going on in their life? Are you able to see that for what it is and not judge, you know, well, you're probably there because of this, and if you just changed yourself, you wouldn't be there. Instead, can you reach out and just your heart feels for them, and you can reach them at their level so that you can perhaps lift them up if they want to be lifted up. You need to reach them at their level instead of kind of condescending or judging or looking down and saying, you should be here. That doesn't help anybody. So realizing how you can come into their level to pull them up, how to come into their level without sinking to that level yourself, though. You don't want to be so overwhelmed with it that you end up truly sinking yourself into that level, whether it's depression or anxiety or anger or whatever the emotions are they're dealing with. You don't want to feel so drawn into that that it becomes your own emotion. Oftentimes, when people are born empathic, that's one of the things they struggle with greatly, is they struggle with really feeling like they get so overwhelmed by everyone they're around, and they just feel like they have such compassion with all of these emotions that they feel around everyone too. So it's learning how to feel it without falling into it per se. And trusting yourself too is a big part of it, that having that greater intuition. Trust yourself when your gut tells you something. Trust that you know what you're feeling. And then having that greater depth, that comes with letting go of judgment, with letting go of criticism, and really seeing that there's so many people in this world with so many backgrounds and so many opinions, and that's what makes our world great, is having this wonderful array of things. It's far less boring when you have a great array of things. Just like if you're cooking a magnificent soup, you're not just gonna have one flavor in it, you're gonna blend a lot of flavors. That makes it more complex, it gives it greater depth. So recognizing how to bring more depth into yourself. And then that deep connection to people and that deep connection to the earth is with the deep connection to the earth, that's an easy one. Feel for the heartbeat of the Mother Earth and see what can you do to help bring the earth back to an easier balance. Humans have this strong history of kind of trampling over Mother Earth and really using whatever we want for our resources. So being more conscious, being more heart-centered with the earth. And those same things will apply with people. How many people do you know that you've seen where they just kind of trample over others to get what they want, to rise to the top, to be whatever they want, have what they want? And then if somebody else needs them, they're not really there for them. So how can you deepen your connection with other people, which ties right back into that compassion? So those are some of the great strengths that empaths tend to have. If you're somebody who's very naturally empathic, see those as strengths within yourself. Recognize that you have warrior or warrioress abilities in you, and you can have this deep compassion, and you have this depth within yourself, and this intuition, and that that compassion where you can feel the earth and you feel for other people. And then the key becomes to raise yourself up so you don't fall into that hole with them, but you can recognize where you are, and you're able to see that you are separate from them, but you can put yourself into their shoes. You don't bear their shoes like an iron weight. You can just easily slip back and forth. Know who you are, know what shoes fit you, know where you are at in life, and then you can easily trade places to see and have that empathy come back to yourself and your own grounding. Which brings me to the second part of today's Life Talk, which is strategies to be a happy, successful empath. And it's so interesting with a topic like this, because you have people truly on both sides, those that want to increase those empathic abilities and those that if they could, they would just shirk them away and never feel all of that emotion again. So this is all about bridging that into a happy, successful, healthy way. So one of the big things with empathy is to practice self-care. If you're somebody who is always feeling and you feel like you're just so empathic that you know what's going on with other people, perhaps even when you're around animals, you can feel what they're thinking. You feel what they're going through. When you're in line at the grocery store, this is an example I use in a lot of of things because it's something a lot of people talk to me about, is being overwhelmed when they're in public. So when you're in line at the grocery store and you've been okay through the day and suddenly you feel just overwhelmingly sad or overwhelmingly frustrated, and you look around and you realize it's the person standing next to you that is feeling that way, but you're just overwhelmed with it, and then you walk out of the store continuing to feel that way. That's not good. You might have either had a cord attached with that person who was just a stranger in line with you for a few minutes, and perhaps they've been in that for a while and so they needed a little energy boost. So they unknowingly attached part of their aura to you, and so then you're fueling off of that and they're pulling some of your energy out of you. So it's things about practicing self-care. So one of the things is to cut cords. A lot of times empaths have this beautiful aura around them, and other people can subconsciously know that that's someone who cares. And often there are so many people in this world who feel like nobody really cares about them. They're afraid that they don't know if they really matter in this life, and they feel like they're suffering and there might not be anybody who really understands or cares. And so when they're walking among other strangers and they haven't even talked to you, but part of their higher self can sense that you're a very compassionate, caring person. So they might have attached into you. Some people would refer to it as an energy vampire, even in ways, although that sounds a little harsher. There's some people that more consciously will attach those cords, but a lot of people unknowingly do. So cutting and clearing those cords off of your body. We did a previous life talk where we talked about some methods for that. But you can cut and clear those cords. Free yourself from everyone who is sucking out your energy. Free yourself from any of those energy drains is a huge part of it. And then reclaiming your power. So once you cut and clear all of those cords, you can even ask the Archangel Michael to help cut and clear those cords. He's the warrior angel. He has a sword. He's really good at cutting and clearing those cords. And so you can feel yourself get free from that and then reclaim your power back to yourself. Maybe you'll want to take a wide stance, spread your feet out, spread your arms out, and then repeat to yourself, "I call all of my power back to me now." And repeat that several times, getting louder each time, and you're going to feel your energy just go whew, right back into yourself. And you'll feel empowered within yourself, and you'll be able to separate all those things that you were feeling from other people and where they were draining you. That's going to clear away, and you're getting your energy back. When there's cords with other people, which empaths sometimes, if they're not doing it in a really healthy way, they have all these cords. And so you're draining your energy. It's being siphoned to these people who need an extra boost and who felt your compassion. So call that energy back to you. It's not going to hurt the people who are draining off of you. They will be just fine. They'll actually be a little bit freer because they're not going to have your cord that's leaning into them either. So that's one of the big things. That's one of the biggest things that will really help people that are overwhelmed with being empathic. So being a happy, successful empathic is practicing self-care too. So you're learning to trust yourself. You're reaching out, you're feeling the emotions of others, and you're learning to differentiate what you feel. A big part of it is knowing what you feel. You have to know who you are. You have to learn to understand what you're feeling so that you can know when it's your emotion or when it's somebody else's emotion. And you can learn to reach out, feel someone else, but then come back and know who you are and know what your emotions are too. So some of the other things for self-care are just simply taking care of yourself. Maybe getting a massage, getting a Reiki treatment. Maybe you're more into sports, so hitting something will work better to help clear your mind. Power walking, having healthy food in your life. All of these things are really important for self-care. Eating fresh, healthy, live foods like fruits and vegetables and things like that are really a big part of keeping your energy up. It's going to raise your vibration. When your vibration is higher, you're naturally able to reach out to feel and to understand and to be empathic, as well as you're creating this healthy, vibrant, radiant energy within yourself. Meditation is also a big key, both to increasing your empathy, if that's what you're wanting to do, and also to preserving yourself. So meditation, you can use that to release. And let go of anything that's not part of you. You can use that to connect down to the earth. So many people that are empathic are not wanting to connect to the earth because they feel like they're going to feel the suffering of everybody. Well, as the earth is a balanced place. Just as much as there is suffering in the earth, there's a lot of joyful people out there too. There's a lot of people that are celebrating, whether it's an anniversary or a wedding or a birthday or they just got a job. All of those happy emotions are just as abundant on this earth as the suffering. So you can choose through meditation to train your mind to connect down to the earth and connect to your own little part of the earth, knowing that you have the sure footing underneath you that is your part of the earth. It doesn't have to pull in anything from anybody else. And then if you're increasing your empathy and you're reaching out, or you're needing to bring a little bit more happy balance into yourself as you're connecting to the earth, you can imagine all the people that are having a really good day. Think about the things that people are celebrating today that you might not know these people, but think about joyful times in life and know that there's somebody out there. There are so many people on this planet. There are probably several people out there having exactly what you're thinking about at that moment. And so there is so much joy abundant in the earth. And so being able to connect into that, meditate, release, connect to the earth. And then learning to breathe first is another thing, both with increasing your empathy and also protecting yourself if you're overwhelmed with empathy. Whenever you feel like you're in a situation and your mood suddenly shifts from what it was a moment ago, then take a breath and recenter yourself, straighten your spine, and feel that you have your own column of light. You are connected to the divine, you're connected to the earth, and you can claim your whole space right around you and know that that's just your space. And so breathe first. Remember what your emotion is. Know who you are. And then after you've breathed a couple times, then focus in on, okay, now what was I just feeling and where did that come from? Look around you. See who's around you. Is it someone you know? Is it someone you don't know? And then work on pinpointing whose emotion were you just picking up on. And then once you focus on seeing that, maybe you'll want to smile at them. Maybe you'll want to send them a little bit of light. And just sending them some love. You could say a little prayer for that person. You can ask Reiki to help that person if it's something that was negative or felt sorrowful. Not that it's negative, but something that felt on the lower frequencies of energies. Or maybe you can even start focusing on how to be empathic and pick up the good things from others. Far too often, people focus on being empathic and knowing how to care for somebody, how to see the harder emotions, but you can do it just as much. So to focus on seeing the joy, seeing the happy, feeling the spontaneous excitement that people have. So really learning to reach out, exercise that muscle within your brain, that supramarginal gyrus, and exercise that so that you can learn to flex it and really feel the emotions with everybody around you, and so that you can have that extra compassion. This will increase your intuition in a number of ways. And then you also want to surround yourself with happy, positive, radiant people too. If you're empathic, it's important to have a circle of friends around you that are also wonderful, that are happy. None of us are happy 100% of the time. Life has a lot of emotional waves that we go through, and it's good to experience that wave so that you can appreciate the highs. You know, if we were always up here with our emotions, that would eventually feel dull because we don't know what it feels like to be down here. But surrounding yourself with people that are supportive is a big key to taking care of yourself. Often when people get depressed, they tend to shut people out, which is the worst thing that you can do for yourself. So surround yourself with good people. If you don't feel like you have that in your life right now, start looking around and seeing how and where can you find people that might be like-minded, that can bring some of that positive influence in your life, and work on yourself too. There's a saying that you can always tell a lot about yourself by looking around at who your friends are. And so if you feel like the people around you are just not where you want to be, then also look inside and see what can you heal within yourself. What can you maybe release, let go of, clear, and heal so that you feel more content, so you feel happier. And as you start healing that, you're going to be opening up your life to more people that are positive. Sometimes in that step, it takes letting go of the people in your life and possibly being a little bit alone for a brief time, which can really teach you a whole lot about yourself, because when you're alone and you have that quiet space, you have time to really look in the mirror and see who you are as a person. And that can help really heal to get you to where you want to be and bring in that circle of influence that you want around you. Keeping energy vampires away is a big key too. Sometimes we feel like there are certain types of relationships you just can't get away from, but there are certain keys that you can do to protect yourself and also to release some of those too. Our society says we have to be around certain people, and we don't really have to be around anybody that we don't choose. And so it can be a little trickier if it's a work situation sometimes. Maybe your boss is somebody that you have a hard time with. So figuring out what you can do, how you can make changes in your life, clear out the energy vampires. Make sure that you're not one yourself too. Sometimes people feel like they're surrounded by energy vampires. Well, maybe you need to look a little bit in yourself and make sure that's not a trait that you have as well. Nobody wants to be like that, but sometimes that can happen and we just don't realize what we're doing. So it takes really taking that time, that self-exploration, looking and seeing what needs to be healed within yourself. And cutting the cords, clearing, releasing, claiming your own power. I already mentioned that. That's a big key. Trusting yourself, too, is another big key. Learning to trust your intuition, trust your gut, trust your feelings, and don't let your feelings overwhelm you. Instead, recognize what the feelings are, recognize the emotion, recognize where it comes from, and then choose consciously, logically, what you want to do with it. You don't want to run your life just on emotion, because that creates a lot of drama in the life, and it creates a situation where you feel like you're on this huge roller coaster. It's okay to recognize the emotion, to see it, to examine it, pull it in, and then also release it and keep yourself oriented on what you want in your life, what you're looking for in your life, and what you can do to support the people around you to be compassionate, to help possibly heal the people around you as well as yourself. And then being grateful is another big key. I've talked about this in many different things, but gratitude is one of the biggest keys for having a happy, successful life. Whether you're trying to increase your skills of being an empath or being more intuitive, what you focus on is what you attract. And so if you think about the people you're grateful for in your life, if you don't have people you're grateful for, think about the animals you're grateful in your life, or think about the environment. Maybe all you can think of right now are the fall colors are really beautiful. Start with something that you're grateful for. Reach out of yourself. Clear, let go of those past thoughts. Clear, let go of your judgments. Clear, let go of what your opinions and viewpoints are when you're stepping into somebody else's shoes. And being grateful for yourself, being grateful for things is really one of those key things to balance that will help you as you're working on this journey towards becoming more empathic. And if you're already very empathic and you're just wanting to be happier about it and learning to recognize where it's you and where it's them, finding your gratitude in every situation, there's something that you can find to be grateful for. Sometimes it's a bit harder to find than others. Doing that gratitude box that we talked about frequently last year, that's an excellent way to focus on what you're grateful for and to be able to look over the past years to see what you're grateful for. This is a perfect time of year to start your gratitude box too, because we are coming up very quickly to Samhain, which is a time of celebration for the new year, as the wheel of the year through nature starts to end one cycle with the harvesting and all of that life, and we begin to enter into the new year where the ground again becomes covered over with frost and ice soon, and we start to plant anew. So this is a perfect time to release and let go and start that gratitude journal so that you can really see next year all the things you had to be grateful for this year. I hope you enjoyed this life talk on how to become more empathic and how to be a happy, successful empath as well. I look forward to seeing you next week, and I hope you have share this video if you haven't already, and like and subscribe to us on Facebook and YouTube at Earth and Sky Center. Thank you. Have a great week.